Dear Lana, today I am going to discuss the topic operators and expressions. This topic is from the course Computer Programming Using C Language. Today I am going to discuss mainly the definition of operators, the definition of expressions, what are the different types of operators used in C language, and the precedence and associativity of operators. Now, what is operator? An operator is defined as a symbol that specifies the mathematical, logical, or relational operators to be performed. C language supports various types of operators. And now let me discuss what is operator and what is operand. Suppose I have written a statement, A plus B. Here, this A and B, these are known as operands. And this is an operator. It is a plus symbol is a binary operator because it operates on two operands. That's why it is known as a binary operator. Similarly, minus, division, modulus, multiplication, these are all binary operators. And what is unary operator? Unary operator operates only on single operand. I have written a statement A plus plus. Here, this increment operator is a unary operator because it operates only on single operand. This is operator. That means operator is a symbol. Now, what is expression? An expression is a combination of variables, constants, and operators written according to the syntax of the language. In C language, every expression evaluates to a value. That is, every expression results in some value of a certain type, and that can be assigned to a variable. Let me write an expression. Sum equal to A plus B. This is an expression. The result of these two variables is stored in this variable sum. This is an expression. It is a combination of operators and operands and sometimes constants. Now I am going to discuss the types of operators. C language supports various types of operators, and those are first one is arithmetic operator, next logical operator, relational operator, conditional operator, midrange operator, assignment operators, size of operator, and unary operator, which includes increment and decrement operator, increment and decrement operator. These are the operators used in C language. Now let me discuss the arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators can be applied to any integer and floating point numbers. The addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, these arithmetic operators perform the usual arithmetic operation in C programs. But the modulus operator performs differently. Modulus operator is denoted by the percentage symbol and it gives the remainder of the division. And division operator gives the result of a division. Let me discuss with an example. This is modulus operator. This is an example of arithmetic operator, and this is denoted by this symbol percentage. Suppose 5 mod 2, it gives 1. That means it gives the remainder, this. And division operator is denoted by this symbol. And suppose 5 divided by 2, it will give 2, result of this one. Division operator gives this value, and this modular operator gives this value, remainder of a division. So dear learner, I have listed all the arithmetic operators in a table. Let me discuss that. Suppose I have taken 5 in the variable A and 2 in the variable B. Then the plus operator gives A plus B equal to 7. Similarly, the subtraction operator gives A minus B, 5 minus 2 equal to 3. Multiplication gives A into B, that means it will result 10. Similarly, division operator gives the result of a division, that means 5 divided by 2, it will give 2, and the modulus operator gives the remainder of a division, A mod B equal to 1. I have written the use of all these arithmetic operators in a simple C program. It is written in this C program. Here in this program, initially I have declared 2 variables n1 and n2 for storing the numbers. Then there are some other variables like sum, sub, mul, mul, then division and mod to store the result of these arithmetic operators. First, I have entered the value of 2 variables in the variable n1 and n2. Then in the sum variable, the addition is stored. Then in the next statement, the summation is displayed with the help of the printf statement. After that, sub equal to n1 minus n2. That means the subtraction of the two number is stored in this variable sub. After that, the difference is displayed with the help of a printf statement. Like this, the multiplication, division and modulus is calculated. And the output of this program is like this. Here the input numbers are 10 and 3, the sum is 13, the difference is 7, the product is 30, and division is 3, and the modulus is 1. This is a simple example of a C program where I have shown all the uses of arithmetic operators. Relational operator can be used to determine the relationship between the operands. A relational operator is also known as the comparison operator. Relational operator returns true or false depending on whether the conditional relationship between the two operands holds or not. True means the value 1 and false means the value 0. Suppose I have taken an expression x less than y. If x is less than y, it gives true value, that means 1. If x is greater than y, then it gives false value, and that is, it will give 0. Here I have shown all the relational operators in a tabular format. First one is less than, second one is less than or equal to, third one is greater than, fourth one is greater than or equal to, then equal to operator, then not equal to operator. Equal to operator is expressed with double equal to sign, and with the help of single equal to sign, we in C language only assignment operator is expressed. Here I have shown some examples. 4.5 less than equal to 12. As 4.5 is small as compared to 12, so it is a true statement, so it gives true value, that means 1. Similarly, minus 6 greater than 0. It is a false statement because minus 6 is always less than 0. So it will result 0. Similarly, 10 less than 7 plus 5. Here 7 plus 5 is calculated first. 7 plus 5 is equal to 12. 10 less than 12. It is true. So it will give 1. And in the next statement, 4 is equal to 2. It is false. So it gives 0 value. Now I will discuss the logical operators. There are three logical operators. There are three logical operators in C language. These are logical and, which is denoted by this double ampersand symbol, then logical or, which is denoted by pipe, and logical not. This is denoted by this negation symbol. These are the three logical operator used in C language. Logical AND operator is used to simultaneously evaluate two conditions with relational operators. If the condition on both sides of the logical operator is true, then the whole expression is true. Suppose I have written a statement, if A greater than B and A greater than C, then I will store the maximum value here on this variable max. In this expression, this is an expression. This is the left hand side of an expression, this is the right hand side of an expression, and this is the logical AND operator. If both these conditions are true, suppose A is greater than B, and suppose this is also true, and suppose this is also true, then only A is assigned to max. Both conditions should be true in case of logical AND. If one is false, if this condition is false, or if this condition is true, then it will not come to this statement. In logical AND operator, both conditions should be true. And the truth table for logical AND operator is like this. Suppose this is the first expression, this is the second expression, and this is A and B. Suppose first expression is 0, that means false. Second expression is also 0. Then after logical AND, the result will be 0. First expression is false, second expression is suppose true, that is 1. Then the result will be also 0. First expression is true, 1. Second expression is 0. Then the result will be 0. If both the expressions are true, then only result will be 1. This is the truth table for logical AND operator. In logical OR operator, if one or both the conditions on the left hand side and the right side of the logical operator is true, then the whole expression is true. In logical OR operator, if one or both the conditions on the left hand side and right hand side of the logical operator is true, then only the whole expression is true. Suppose in this expression I am modifying it, this with the logical OR operator. In case of logical OR operator, only left hand side or right hand side, only one partition is necessary to be true. Suppose this is true, this is false, then max will be, sorry, then only result will be true, that means 1. If we express this in this truth table, logic truth table for OR operator, here this result will be sense like this, 0, 0, it will give false value, 0, 0, 1, that means false and true, it will give a true value, true and false, it will also give a true value, and true, true, it will also a true value. Only one expression is required to be true in case of logical OR operator. And the third operator, and the third operator is logical NOT. This is denoted by this symbol. Suppose A is a number and NOT A. Suppose this is the truth table for logical NOT. Suppose A is 0, then it only reverse the number, it will be 1. Suppose A is true, it will revert this like this, it will be false. This is the logical NOT operator. That is, logical NOT produces a 0 if the expression evaluates to a non-zero value, and produces a 1 if the expression produces a 0 value. Now I am coming to assignment operators. Assignment operators, I have already told that the single equal sign is denoted, is used for assignment operator, and double equal sign is used for equal to sign. Assignment operator is used to assign a value to a variable. Suppose I want to assign a value to a variable. This is the assignment operator and this is the equal to operator. Suppose I want to assign a value to a variable. Suppose I have declared a variable like this, integer a. Suppose a equal to 20. That means 20 is assigned to a. The value 20 is assigned to a. This variable stores the value 20. Similarly, suppose I have, in the next statement I have written 40. That means 40 is assigned to, new value of a is 40. Now 40 is assigned to a. This is the use of assignment operator. The assignment operator equal to and the equality operator double equal to are definitely distinctly different. The assignment operator is used to assign a value to a variable, whereas the equality operator is used to determine if the two expressions have the same value. There are some shorthand assignment operators. That means we can write a single statement in different way. Let me show this in a tabular format. Here, a equal to a plus 1. That means 1 is added to a and this value is assigned to the variable a. This can be written as a plus equal to 1. In the next statement, a equal to a minus 1 is same as a minus equal 1. In the same way, the last statement, a equal to a mod b, in this statement it can be written as a mod equal to b. These are shortcut operators, assignment operators. We can write this statement in a different way, like this. Now let me discuss what is conditional operator. Conditional operator is a ternary operator because it uses three operands. The syntax of writing a conditional operator is like this. Let me write the syntax. Expression 1. expression 2, expression 3. I have used this combination of these two symbols. This is the symbol of conditional operator. Here, if this condition is, this is the syntax. If this expression or condition is true, if this condition is true, it will result this value. And if this condition is false, it will give this value. In this way, this conditional operator works. Here, three operands are used, this expression, and this expression, and this expression. So, it is known as ternary operator. Because there are three operands. Let me take an example. A equal to 10, B equal to 15. That means 10 is assigned to A and 15 is assigned to B. Then in the next statement, X equal to A greater than B. I have used this question mark, then A, then colon, then B, and then after that a semicolon. Here, value of B will be assigned to X because B is 15 and A is 10. A greater than B is false because 10 is less than 15. So it will give the third part, that means expression 3, and which is here B. The value 15 will be the output of this two statement. I have written one example to describe the use of conditional operator. Here in this program, it will display whether the user is eligible for vote or not. If the age is greater than equal to 18, then the user will be eligible for vote, otherwise he will not be able to vote. For this program, I have written this main part. I have declared first one a variable, integer age. In this output statement, enter your age in years. When the user enters his age, with the help of this input statement scanf, then age will be stored in this variable age. After that, a conditional statement operator statement is used here. In this statement, if age greater than equal to 18, then first symbol is used, question mark, printf, you can vote. Then I have used one colon, printf, you cannot vote. If this condition A is greater than equal to 18, if this condition is true, then the first part you can vote will be displayed. If this condition is false, then the second part you cannot vote will be displayed. If the user enters suppose 24 as an input, then the first statement you can vote will be the output of this program. If he enters suppose 15, that means his age is 15, then you cannot vote will be displayed. This is a simple program for determining whether a person is eligible for vote or not. In the next class, I will discuss unary operator, binary operator, then bitwise operator, comma operator, and size of operator. After that, I will discuss one important topic, which is precedence and associativity operator. Thank you.